Good evening and welcome to television, Studio 10 style.
It was the 16th of September 1956 when Bruce Gyngell uttered those famous words. And I have to say, Bruce, you haven't aged a day.
Well, I appreciate that, Sarah, and you look very dashing, don't you? I'd like to see you in my office after the program.
That's how they did things. Exactly. We asked our loyal Studio 10 viewers to vote on your favourite TV moments, and TV historian Andrew Mercado is here with all of the results. Hi, Andrew.
Hello. Hi, Andrew.
Now, before we get into it, Bruce Gyngell is credited with being the very first person to appear on television, but he really wasn't technically, was he? Oh.
Well, technically he wasn't, because they were testing the cameras and the broadcast and all that with a whole bunch of other people. But certainly on the night the TV started, Bruce was the first guys to say those immortal words. And they didn't have a studio ready at that time at Channel 9. They just did a little church hall at Surrey Hills. They just had to be first, right? Nothing's changed.
Yeah. Wow.
But interestingly, one of the people they say was doing the test broadcasts was Graham Kennedy. And I know he's one of your favourites,
I. Oh, yes, I loved Graham. And I love the way he set up commercials. And, you know, one day we went on the John Law's 30th anniversary mystery flight to God knows. We didn't go anywhere in particular, we were all up there. And he was like a lot of performers, he was very shy off the camera. Mm. And we sat together and we had a fantastic conversation. I really enjoyed it.
And I think it's no surprise that the King is right up there with the favourite TV moments.
Absolutely. The Graham Kennedy in Melbourne Tonight Show was a huge show. I don't think anyone ever topped that in terms of variety in this country, and they didn't call him the king for nothing. He really was the king of TV. He understood the medium. His dog didn't behave as well as Katrina Warren's dog did then. His dog, he did these live ads, and of course things went wrong, and sometimes the dog lifted its leg live on TV.
Let's have a look, shall we?
Rover. Oh, he's.
Oh no.
Which is what Jono does as well in the studio. Leave him. He has too much to drink beforehand.
Oh, he's.
So my favourite moment, and I reckon there's a whole generation of girls out there, and I think it's your favourite TV moment too, was of course when Angry Anderson sang as Charlene.
Scott and Charlene got married in Neighbours. Incredible to think that Neighbours was nearly axed twice in the lead up to this moment, and then a year later, this TV wedding will never be topped on Australian TV. Yep. And it went all around the world. You know, they say 26 million Brits watched this episode.
Bit
raunchy.
I think it was 2 million people or something watched it.
Oh, it would have been huge back then. So, yeah, but poor old Neighbours has never been able to top that wedding, you know. It was such a peak moment in their history.
Mm. We had a country's practices and Tenny on this week with that amazing dying scene.
Yeah.
And she's made the cut too, hasn't she?
Oh, yeah. If Scott and Charlene are our greatest ever TV wedding, the saddest death was Molly dying in a country practice as she watched Brendan and Chloe playing with the kite there. Look at it. You know, a lot of young kids in the country were so upset when this happened. You know, a generation of young kids really didn't cope.
Well, it's taken 30 years for Australia to get over it. Yeah. And then we played it again this week.
Yeah,
the whole thing.
Brings it all back.
It was scarring.
Yeah.
It was horrible.
Yeah, when Ray Desmond left the show, she actually said, "You cannot kill me off like Molly. I do not want to upset the young kids. I want to get into a taxi and go off."
Andrew, our AEP is a sadist, so he'd like us to watch these final moments.
No, here it is. Oh. Here it is. I can't bear it. We've just traumatised an entire new generation.
She went to a better place.
Yeah, that's right. She's gone to heaven now.
All right, live television can be very dangerous. Oh, yes.
Terribly dangerous.
Yes, it can.
We've all found most ironic auto-cue moment.
And the next viewer moment really caused an outcry when it appeared, didn't it?
The first series of Big Brother, you know, such a huge thing on TV. It was our first big, huge reality show. And that first season, all those people are in the house, not even knowing whether anybody's watching the show. But look at this, the infamous bum dance from Sarah Marie. And by the time she got out of the house and into the studio there at Dreamworld, the entire audience was wearing the pink bunny ears like her, and they were all doing the bum dance. This is just one of those crazy moments on Australian TV that caught on.
Ita can do the bum dance.
Well, I'm not doing it today.
So which show is celebrating a landmark this weekend?
Well, 40 years ago tonight, a bomb went off in number 96. This was a huge show at the time. Do you know what? I put together the DVD for this, the episodes before and after, and they hold up really well. And this split-screen technique, no one had ever seen that on TV before, but they used real gelignite in this explosion. They did it on a Saturday, closed set, put bulletproof glass in front of the cameras, and when they set this bomb off, the blast was so great, it blew open all the studio doors at North Ryde.
No.
I mean, you'd never do that today with health and safety. But, you know, four people died in this bomb blast on TV, and on the Monday when they reported on the deaths, the Daily Telegraph had to keep reprinting and reprinting. It was such a huge selling issue for them.
Wow. Andrew Mercado, you have wonderful insights into Australian TV history. We love it. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.